Let us understand the term database administrator by observing an activity most of us indulge in. The activity is withdrawing money from a bank. While you are withdrawing money, there are quite a few things happening in the background. Thousands of other customers may be doing the same thing, and this is not affecting you in any way. Access to your data is important where banking is concerned. You could ask your bank for past account transactions, and the bank has an obligation to provide it. Since banking is a frequent activity, performance is taken for granted. When at an ATM, you expect your transaction to be completed quickly. Now let us look at things from a bank's perspective. What we are seeing here is a vast quantity of data that the bank has to store and provide its customers. This data is stored on databases, but as we saw, it's more than just data. There is the concept of concurrency, where data can be accessed by multiple customers. The concept of data security, where your data is protected. The concept of performance, where data is accessible in acceptable time frames. Data and this extra functionality is made possible by a DBMS, or Database Management System. And the people responsible for managing a DBMS are DBAs, or database administrators. Databases are present in a wide spectrum of companies who recruit DBAs to look after this data. DBAs are involved in a variety of activities. They install and maintain databases. They upgrade databases to newer versions when available. They take backups of databases so data can be recovered if a system crashes. They also export data across databases. Monitoring databases is another component of a DBA's average day. They run tests to measure the health of a database. For example, databases can fill up, which means that no more information can be added. When this happens, work can grind to a halt. Similarly, performance can become an issue, resulting in calls to customer service agents, which companies never want. So this means that a DBA has to also be a problem solver. DBAs also plan and implement security measures to safeguard databases. As a customer, you would not want your banking or medical records to fall into the wrong hands. How can one become a DBA? Let's start with education. Typically, a bachelor's degree in an area of computing in which you would have taken at least one database course. Companies generally require that you are proficient in vendor-specific solutions such as SQL Server, Oracle, DB2, etc. Also, having a good grasp of at least one programming language, or maybe two, is also very helpful. Then there is the topic of certification. Certifications firstly help you in increasing your knowledge of the subject and can also open doors for you during interviews. Now, what do you do if you do not have a formal IT degree? One option is to obtain certification. Another option is to get into a role that does not need an IT degree and then work your way to becoming a DBA. Role changes happen at all times in companies, so this is possible. Now let us focus on some of the soft skills needed. You should be good at and enjoy problem solving. Then the subject matter itself is dynamic. New versions and concepts are introduced frequently, so you've got to keep yourself up to date. Now imagine yourself as a DBA. What are some of the joys and challenges of your job? Let's start with the joys. You are part of a very relevant area of work. It is a complex area, a vast area, and a very dynamic one. Furthermore, it is a mission-critical area. As a DBA, your skill set is generally domain-independent. This fact makes your skills portable across industries. So today you could be a DBA in the insurance industry and tomorrow in another industry. But having said so, a domain or industry can have very specific data-related needs. DBAs in telecom industries, for example, are highly sought after for their skills in handling very large volumes of data. Now let's look at the other side of the coin. A DBA does not necessarily need to know the business in order to administer its data. And this may not be good, since domain knowledge is very useful. DBAs are under pressure to ensure the data is always available to employees and customers. Some companies may run critical operations during certain time periods. This may require a DBA's presence at odd hours to ensure that everything runs smoothly. So what is a DBA's progression path? Within the organization, you could start as a junior DBA, then work your way to being an intermediate DBA, followed by a senior DBA. At this point, you have a choice. You could be a manager or an architect. A DBA manager manages a team of DBAs. So what is the difference between an architect and a DBA? Well, a DBA focuses on administering data, while the architect focuses on designing the look and feel of this data. On the other hand, there are companies where full-time DBAs are not recruited. In this case, you could work as a consultant.